So let's talk about treatment of acute bacterial rhinosinusitis. So generally we do not give antibiotics. So there are some certain indications for prescribing antibiotics, like a patient can't come for follow-up, okay? Or if there is worsening symptoms during observation. Worsening symptoms during observation. Okay, so we observe a patient and do symptomatic management and can give intranasal glucocorticoids, okay, but no antibiotics. We follow up and see if he or she progresses to any complication, okay, or symptoms unchanged after 7 days of observations, or symptoms unchanged after 7 days of observation. Okay, so if patient has these conditions, then we can start antibiotics. Okay, so which antibiotics to choose? So it depends upon patient has penicillin allergy or not. Okay, so if patient does not have penicillin allergy, no penicillin allergy. So if patient does not have penicillin allergy, then we assess whether patient is at risk, has risk factors for pneumococcal resistance or not. Okay, if patient has pneumococcal resistance, then we give amoxiclav. Okay, amoxiclav. If there is no pneumococcal resistance, then we can give just amoxicillin. Okay, or here a dose of amoxiclav is 2000 mg and by 125 mg, extended release tablet twice daily. But here also amoxiclav can be given, but the dose is low, 500 mg by 125 mg, 3 times daily, or 875 mg by 125 mg twice daily. So, but here it is 2000, so high dose here is given. But if there is no resistance, pneumococcal resistance, then we can give amoxiclav low dose as well, okay? So what are the risk factors for pneumococcal resistance? How can you say whether patient has pneumococcal resistance or not? So there are some certain criteria that will help you to say that patient has pneumococcal resistance, okay? So if patient age is greater than 65 years old, then we suspect that patient may have pneumococcal resistance. Or if patient was hospitalized within the last 5 days, okay, or antibiotic used in previous month, or if immunocompromised, or multiple comorbidities like diabetes or heart disease, liver disease, renal disease, okay. So, and other condition is severe infections, like patient is toxic appearing with temperature greater than 102 degree Fahrenheit. So in these cases, we suspect that patient may be having pneumococcal resistance or may be having risk of poor outcome. That's why, in that way, we decide here, okay? And if patient have penicillin allergy, if let's say patient is allergic to penicillin, then we ask whether he or she is able to tolerate cephalosporins, okay? Because penicillin allergy does not always mean cephalosporin allergy, okay? And if patient is able to tolerate cephalosporins, then we can give cephalosporins, third generation cephalosporins, okay? Third generation cephalosporins, or we can give doxycycline, okay? So third generation cephalosporin and doxycycline can be given. And if patient is not able to tolerate cephalosporin, then we can give doxycycline, okay? And we monitor on these antibiotics. So we monitor patient on antibiotic therapy, okay? Monitor on antibiotic therapy. So if there is improvement, then treat for 5 to 7 days total, okay, total. And if there is no improvement, say, let's say there is no improvement, then confirm the diagnosis of acute bacterial rhinosinusitis. Okay, the diagnosis of acute bacterial rhinosinusitis can be confirmed clinically in patients in whom there are concerns for complications. Imaging should be obtained. In other patients in whom symptoms are not completely consistent with acute bacterial rhinosinusitis, imaging is reasonable to rule out sinusitis and or evaluate for alternate diagnosis. Okay, so if the diagnosis is confirmed, let's say, so if there is no improvement, confirm the diagnosis of acute bacterial rhinosinusitis. And if diagnosis is confirmed, then we ask whether there is concern for complications, whether there is any concern for complications or not, like signs and symptoms of complications include toxic appearance, altered mental status and neurological deficits, and evidence of infections into surrounding tissue, soft tissue. Okay, if there is some concern of complications, then we evaluate accordingly, okay, and treat accordingly. And if there is no concern for complication, then treat with oral antibiotic in different class from the first agent used. Okay, for patients who have received respiratory fluoroquinolone as an initial therapy, antimicrobial resistance is unlikely to be the cause of treatment failure. We often pursue evaluation in such patients in place of or in addition to prescribing a second course of antibiotics. Okay, so if there is concern for complication, then evaluate and treat accordingly. And if there is no concern for complication, then treat with oral antibiotic in different class from the first agent used. Like options include amoxiclav, high dose respiratory fluoroquinolones, like moxifloxacin, levofloxacin, okay, or third generation cephalosporin plus clindamycin. And for penicillin allergic patients, doxycycline can be used. And on if this patient is improving on these antibiotics, then treat for 7 to 10 days total. And if there is no improvement, then imaging should be done. Okay, and refer for otolaryngology for culture and further evaluations. So this was about treatment of acute bacterial rhinosinusitis. Okay, so initially we do conservative management, symptomatic treatment. We don't give antibiotics initially, even if patient is having acute bacterial infections in the rhinosinus. Okay, so that's all.